on December 9th in 1964 is when John Coltrane was said to have recorded A Love Supreme. And this was done just, they say, in one studio session, just in the moment, all at once, love. Like, whatever came out just came out, and that was it. There was nothing else. Nothing else needed to be said. And so, you know, and I've always looked at love like that, like just in the moment. And all of my heart, energy, that's it. That's all I have, you know? And so a lot of times it's how I want things to happen too, like art, just how I'm feeling. Like I live by that moment, you know? I feel like everybody should. That's, you know, that's our life. Like, everybody should be free to do that in the moment. But yeah, Love Supreme. So I've always thought about this concept of what a Love Supreme is. I'll be the first to say my life is a love story. It is the most beautiful love story I can ever write, you know? And I'm lucky. I am so fucking lucky that I've had an amazing life of love. And a lot of that, though, is trying to get through it, through myself, trying to figure out who I am, where I'm going, what this all means. Like, I deal with love, but man, I deal with a lot of heartache. And I don't know, and through pain, art is created, you know? Real talk. And so I've always thought about Love Supreme, and I used to always ask myself and tell myself at a young age, like, this is what I want to do in life. I want to feel this ultimate love. And I used to write about this ultimate love. Like, what is this ultimate love? And how do I reach it? Where do I go? How do I attain it? Like, there is nothing in life like that pinnacle, like that greatness of falling in love. And I just, that's all I can think about is spending my life doing that, you know? And so through that thinking about what a Love Supreme is, I wanted to honor love and do something for love and get out whatever I have to get out about love. And so I look at this day on December 9th, tomorrow. Last year, I took the day to do nothing except come up with something, come up with a rhyme, come up with a poem. With my battles, I've always struggled writing. I can never finish a poem. I, by my catalog, you won't find anything, barely anything finished. I can never complete a feeling, but I have all these feelings of love inside, and so it's been a constant, like, learning thing for me to figure out how to get that out. And so what I did last December 9th is I used that day to honor love by writing about love, by trying to finish something. And I came up with something that I want to share, and that's where this is going. I would like to share some of my work and some of what I, like, see, what I want to be around, what I want to do. I just want to love, you know? And through this project, I'm going to call it a project because it absolutely is. There are four parts to it, of course. Love Supreme has four parts. And the part I'm focusing on first is just acknowledgement. Knowing that from the time I knew love existed, or I knew that there's this feeling of, I can't even explain it, you know? No words will ever explain love. But since then, I've been writing about it. It's been my journey. My journey that's led me across the world. Because I go wherever for love. I mean, I need this. I'm gonna go where love is. And so it's a multiple project. But the first part is acknowledging it. Acknowledging that, damn, that's my life. Now let me tell about it, you know? And I just want to take this time to acknowledge it, because I feel like there will be a time for me to move on from, you know, and experience other kind of love where I can write about that and expand my horizon, my level of compassion. And so this first part is acknowledgement, and I'm acknowledging that I've lived for that romantic love my entire life. Saying first, I hope this next journey into resolution will help me to conquer areas of love that I know I failed, which is doing more familial love, my family. They know I love the fuck out of my family, but I can do more than I do, and I need to change. I need to change a lot, and so I'm hoping resolution will lead me there, lead me to write about that. But acknowledgement will absolutely led me to write about love. And so for this acknowledgement period that I'd like to share with you all, I'm gonna do just that. And what I'm gonna share is what I wrote last year. Last year, who knew where I was as far as where my heart was? I know where my heart was last year. I was with Nixon, you know, and I was seeing someone else as well, and she was cool. She still is cool. But no, my heart was absolutely like. Figuring that out. But one love that I do know, like, no matter what I do, I know that love's gonna be around, is my best friend Luna. She is absolutely the most astonishing. I just want to say astonishing, because I don't have words for Nina. She is my ride or die. She's absolutely my fucking best friend. And she lives in Florida. We've never lived around each other. We've only interacted the way we interact. But I fucking miss her. I love her. She's my muse. She is absolutely my muse. The most. Tell her every time, marry me! Marry me! She's absolutely my best friend. Like, I can do anything for her. And man, I just want her happy. Fuck, she is just, man, she's so. First, oh man, we have a journey, we have a story that's led us to where we're at, a story that I love to tell, probably not now, it's probably gone already, but But I know the first time that I met Nina, it was in June of, I believe it was 09. Maybe? No, it was 09. Might have been 08. Damn. But anyways, when we initially met, and either way it goes, that was the first time going to initially see each other physically. And I knew that when I met her, I would have to meet her. I was in love with her by that time. I was in love at the beginning. You know, love at first time. At first sight, I love like that. I believe in love like that. Everything. All or nothing. But I knew that when I saw her, that I would have to fall in love with her. Get in love with her and out of love with her right away. I had to fall out of love with her. And how that crazy that is. Like, how do you fall out? You just do. But I had to fall out of love with her immediately, because I knew that if we were to be close, to be friends, to have the relationship that we have now, that we had then too, just to have what we have, like, that's just what it is. And so, and I remember the moment when we first met that I told myself, like, all this life, oh my gosh, I finally met an angel. Not to discredit anybody else, but she was my angel. And so I'm just gonna leave it there. So I wrote about her. I wrote about her last year, and I'd like to share with you all what's built up, our relationship that's built up. And honor that love supreme. And throughout my journey, I want to make sure I honor love more and all the other stories I have to tell. I already know this is long. Yo, whoever's watching this still, just fry away. So, I should break it up later, I don't know. But anyways, a lot of times when I write something, I'm an MC, I want to rhyme it. Like, I want to rhyme it. But at the same time, I realize that sometimes I want to speak it. I don't want the words to be rhymed. I want them to be slowed down so people can understand, like, how I felt about it right then. You know, like, get that out. Like, And so I always believe in, like, figuring out ways to put it out my media in all those different formats, you know, even writing, because I have to write. So what I plan on doing with this is I'm going to share with you all a video that I recorded when, upon our first meeting, first time I met her. And so what I want to do is, I want to break it down. So I had this, you know, I've been thinking about this Love Supreme project for a long time. And so I'll go, you know, I go through beats and I'm like, which one moves my heart? Which one has a song on it? And so, so I've just been finding music for a long time. And so one of these, the day that I wrote this piece that I'm going to share with you, original beat was done by Odyssey. Actually, that's fucked up. I'm sorry. I'm thinking of 60901. No, it was it was an Odyssey beat. What am I talking about? Yeah, Odyssey, and Tyron was rhyming on it. And I apologize if I got your name wrong. But I need to check that fact. I absolutely have to check that fact. Anyways, this beat just, whew, got me. Got me. And I'm going to share it with you real quick. It's love at first sight, after the first night. I never met you before, but love, you feel right. You make my chest feel tight. I knew from the moment that we spoke, love, that you would be my life. And love, you still are. I might not show it, cause love, you live far away. And that's okay, you know I'm here for you. I traveled the world for your smile just to show you. We'd be close, it never mattered if you mattered the most. Probably cause you let me be me. You love me in your own way, always at my own speed. Free enough to fly and fly enough to be free. Wings were only made for my queen. And when she smiles, I hear the whole world sing. Her beautiful lies let me be lost in her dream. I place love above everything. And so That was the beat I used to write to. And I chose to write about her over that beat also because of this video project that I made in my senior year. My undergrad at HT, and it was a memoir class, and we had a digital assignment, like a movie, making a movie, making a visual assignment about love. And so what I did was I took those videos from our first meeting, and I used that video to tell a story. And I guess what I wanted to do, which I guess I haven't tried with those lyrics, was rhyme in between the parts of the video. That was the original thought I would write to, but I'd still like to share the video. And also, I'd like to share, I know this is getting long, thank you. I'd like to share a song that after I wrote this, and I remember probably like a week later, it's the first time we met Guitar. Me, Teo, and Zai, we rode to San Antonio because my boy Lance was like, yo, gotta rhyme. I got some beats you gotta rhyme over. And so, it ended up meeting Guitar. And Guitar, is a Libra, let's say he's a Libra out of San Antonio, a beat maker, producer, and we were talking, first time meeting, and he was like, yo, he said, I have these beats, and I just want somebody to rhyme about love over them, and I'm like, fuck, that's what the fuck fuck I do? I rhyme about love over beats. Give me a beat. And so he gave us a beat. And Cy Young is magnificent. Came up with, I don't know what he comes up with. He just, I don't know where he gets his stuff from. But he came up with a masterful rhyme. And Mr. fucking Smooth Tail Blake, he came up with just a beautiful chorus. And I threw my part, what I wrote, to this beat over it. And it's hard going back all the time hearing it, because I'm like, I got so much passion for that now, like, you know? And I want to share that with you as well. That was just long. But, yeah, I have a lot to share, and I hope whether you read what I have to write or watch or something, just come with me as I tell this love story, as I do that and see what manifests from it.